Well, hello there, goddesses. How are you all today? It's Lisa Borwise here, Motivation Monday. I am going to be your hostess with the mostess, taking you through one of my favorite topics today, which is saying F you to food guilt. So if you have not seen me live before, thank you so very much for coming on board or indeed watching the replay. My name is Lisa Borwise and I consider myself a wellness alchemist. That means I'm the kick-ass catalyst in the transformation of women around the world, strong of mind, body and character. And today, our topic that we're going to be talking about and an amazing freebie that you need to stay to the end to hear about is saying F you to food guilt. So if you're somebody who, pretty much like every other woman that I know, literally thinks bad thoughts of themselves every single day based on what they're eating or what they're doing, then this is the message for you. So as people are coming on board, I'm going to break down a little bit of what we're going to talk about today. Mostly we're going to be talking about literally the crazy statistics about how women feel about guilt in terms of what they're eating and the food that they're putting inside their bodies, what you're going to do about it, and we're also going to bust it so that you never have to feel guilty about what you're eating ever again. Wouldn't that be cool? I think so. So if this is a message that you think others need to hear, then go ahead and press that share button and share it out. I would very much appreciate it. If what we're saying today is resonating with you, then go ahead and put an emoji in the comment section here. Go ahead and throw us up some hearts. Let us know if what we're talking about is going to resonate with you. All right, so let's get started. So what the hell is food guilt? So would it be like mind-blowing for you to know that women, specifically women in the UK, British women, there was a study that was done, spend 3 hours feeling guilty about the food that they've eaten per day. 3 hours just going over and over the fact that they should have eaten that. Maybe I shouldn't have eaten that. Did I eat that? Oh, maybe I should be eating this. Should I have that instead? Or God, I can't believe I ate that. I feel so bad. I'm such a naughty person. Like literally, this is the dialogue that goes off in our heads, right? Here's an even more one. So 87% of women said that they felt calorie guilt on a daily basis. I've eaten too many calories. This is too much. This is a bad thing. I should never have eaten that, right? And it gets worse. Then they said that 66% saying that food brings them the most amount of pleasure, but also the most amount of pain. I mean, since when did food become such a difficult situation specifically for females, right? Oh my goodness, I don't know about you, but when I heard those statistics, like 3 hours a day, what? So here's a little exercise. Where does this food guilt come from? Let's do a little exercise to help you to uncover it. And then if you stay to the end, our amazing freebie from today's live video is going to banish food guilt forever, okay? So first of all, the little exercise is, how many times do you catch yourself saying, oh, I ate something bad, or I'm trying to be good, I'm not gonna eat that bad thing, I'm trying to be good. I mean, the amount of times I hear women say, I'm trying to be good, to reflect the fact that they are not eating certain foods and are eating other foods, but that their inherent goodness, their who they are as a woman is called into question because of something that they're gonna eat or something that they don't eat, right? Seriously. Think about that. How is you as a person changed by your choice to eat a cupcake or not eat a cupcake, or to have that fourth cup of coffee or not have that, or have that fourth glass of wine and not have it, or have a glass of wine in the middle of the afternoon? When did our inherent goodness, who we are in terms of our womanhood, our goodness as a human being, get called into question, right? But we do it every time we eat something. We go, should I have eaten that? Should I not have eaten that? Should I have eaten that later? Should I not, you know, oh, I feel really bad about that. Really shouldn't have. And then just constantly this inner work, this inner mean girl, this inner dialogue just goes over and over and over in our brains. How many other times, I mean, moving beyond even just food guilt, I mean, how many times a day do you hear yourself, you know, say, oh, I should be at home doing that, or I should be talking to him about that, or I should be at home with the kids, or I should be making this for dinner, or, well, what if my boss thinks this of this? I mean, how many times do we ask ourselves questions that end up with shoulds coming out? Yeah? So how do we get over this Well, first of all, let's talk about why we have it, and then I'm going to give you all the tips of how to get over it. But the reason why we have it is that specifically for women, in this day and age, we now live in a what we call guilty all the time world, because we have been told that it's possible for us to have it all. We can have an amazing family, we can have thriving children, we can have a booming career or a booming business, and have the body of a 20-year-old, even when we're in our 40s, our late 40s, okay? Mid to, from 40 onwards, we think we can have that all. We can have the body, we can have the career, we can have the family, and that is okay. That's possible. That's possible for us now, so why shouldn't we have it? The issue becomes in that one, if you're a woman, the problem that tends to happen is when you are doing one thing, you're still thinking about the other things. In fact, women are, our brains are programmed to not be as myopic as men. We're very systematic thinkers. So we are thinking about X, Y, and Z happening at the same time as this. However, it's that constant having all the windows open. You know what I mean? I have all my windows open on my computer. Having all those windows open, constantly thinking about it, that you're never truly present with what it is that you're doing. And in this way, you are never truly giving the thing that's in front of you all of your attention. So you're constantly thinking should. So you're never giving the thing that you are in front of you all your attention, because you've never evaluated what's the most important thing I need to be doing right now. Okay, if we sat down and actually evaluated what's the most important thing for us to be doing right now, based on our values, what's important to us, based on our priorities, then there is no second guessing. You're just 100% present where your feet are, which is what I like to say. Because what we tend to do as women is, because we never feel like we are in the right place, when we're working, we think we should be at home. When we are eating a cupcake, we're not sure whether we should have eaten that cupcake, because we never sat down and figured out whether that cupcake was in our diet plan or not in our diet plan, or is this the way I should be eating or not the way I should be eating. If we're spending time with our spouse, then we're worried about our kids. If we're spending time with our mum and our other family members, then maybe we're not spending time on the work and the projects that we know need to get done. So there's always this sense of should. So work-life balance doesn't exist. Just putting that out there, there's no such thing as work-life balance, but there is presence where your feet are, knowing exactly what you should be doing at any one time. And this is how it's the same, exactly the same for food guilt, knowing exactly what you need to eat, when, at the right time and for the right purpose. And that is what's going to be, it's going to help you to never have to feel food guilt again. Okay, so what if you knew, ladies, what to eat every single day, what your body needed to eat every single day to reach the goals that you want? Now, most ladies, first of all, we never sit down and work out what our goals are. We never sit down and go, well, actually, I want to lose weight, or I want to maintain this amount of body fat, or I want to be strong enough to do this, or I want to be fit enough to be able to run around after the kids. There's no quantifiable goal. So my invitation, first of all, is to create that quantifiable goal, because when it comes to nutrition and when it comes to training, to lose fat and to build strength are two different goals with two different types of protocols for you to follow. To get stronger and to build lean muscle is a different way of eating and exercising than stripping off fat and shredding. Yeah? So if you're a lady, like most of the ladies who come to me and go, I just want to lose a bit of weight, but do you? Because we all know how to lose a bit of weight. We all know that if we just wanted to lose a little bit of weight, we can do that. We can just cut back on what we're eating, maybe going on some more walks, doing a little bit more exercise. But that's not what we want, because we've done that before. We've lost a little bit of weight and automatically it's come back on again. Or it's never enough weight. Because ultimately what you're going for is not the weight loss. What you're going for is, I want to feel a certain way, I want to look a certain way in a dress, etc. So I want to feel good, I want to look good, but we need to quantify that. So let's say your goal, let's get specific, is I want to lose 10 pounds this month. Very specific goal. Or I want to change my body shape so that I can whittle my middle but still keep my curves and maybe de-wobble some legs and feel stronger, okay? So those are two different goals. This is, I want to lose 10 pounds in 1 month, I want weight loss. And this is body shape change. I want to whittle in here, I want to make sure that I've de-wobbled out there. Does that make sense? So let's look at the first one. If you just want to lose weight, and again, you haven't made any decisions where it's coming off necessarily, because you can't when it's weight loss. It just comes off where you don't want it to, right, ladies? Mostly the boobs for most people, or here and maybe not your midsection, who knows? So if that's the case, then you need to follow a program that has a calorie deficit, okay? You need to be consuming or consuming less calories than you're burning. That's a calorie deficit. That is the premise of all weight loss, the premise of how to shift unwanted weight. That's the science, okay? And what I'm going to show you today is your TD calculator, which is going to calculate the amount of calories that you need to achieve that. And not just this pull some random 1200 calorie out of a hat malarkey, okay? Now, if you want to achieve body shape change has two processes, the building of lean muscle and the shredding of fat. So some of the time you need to be in calorie surplus to build muscle. You cannot build muscle in a calorie deficit. You need to be in calorie surplus, and you need to eat the right things at the right time for the right reasons. Different macronutrients, proteins, carbs, and fats. And you also need to shed fat at the same time, which means sometimes you need to be in a calorie deficit. Okay, you still with me? Holding in here? Okay, so let's look at these two goals. If this is your goal, this is just a static goal. This is how many calories I need to consume, and if I continue to do this, I will lose weight. The problem with most ladies is that they just pull out a number and go to, no, they either do one of two things. One, they pull out a number and go 1200 calories, because somebody somewhere said 1200 calories was the amount of calories that you could consume. 3% of the female population needs to consume 1200 calories for a significant calorie deficit. For the 97%, this can be extremely harmful to their metabolic functioning, stall their metabolism, which is ultimately what we need to ramp up if they want to lose weight, and can have massive effects on your thyroid, on your other organs, on fatigue, on, and then a host of other problems that can happen. So if you want to know exactly what you need to do to just be in enough of a calorie deficit for the pounds to come off consistently, then you need my TD calculator. TD stands for total daily energy expenditure. How much energy does your body, with your height, your weight, your age, and your sex, females and males slightly different, how much does your body need per day, also based on the amount of exercise that you currently do, how active you are, need to be in a calorie deficit for you to lose weight? If you knew that exact number, what would that do to you in terms of food guilt? You would have no more food guilt because you'd know exactly what you need to be eating every single day, right? Well, that's one part of the equation. So it's true. This is going to tell you how many calories that you, your body, based on your goal, need to consume to lose weight. So it's going to show you that, okay? So I'm going to give you a link to my personal TD calculator, the total daily energy expenditure. And that's going to be helping you to work out what a calorie deficit is for your body, right? It's also going to do it in a way that's healthy. It's also going to do it in a way that's not going to wreck your skin, give you IBS problems, bloating, not going to mess with your thyroid, all of these amazing things, okay? Okay, but say, for example, you've thought about this. Well, I know that I can lose 10 pounds, or I have lost 10 pounds before, but my body didn't look the way I wanted to, and I didn't feel the way I wanted to. And maybe you've hit, 35, 40, and this whole eating less and moving more thing hasn't worked for you. You need to look at body shape change. So body shape change is reducing fat whilst also building lean muscle. So it's the process of building lean muscle so you can add to the areas you want to, but also you can tone, I hate the word, you can lean up your body so that it can de-wobble. That's another word that I use that people seem to understand. But also it's going to give you the shape that you want. When you also focus on building lean muscle, you'll get stronger, your joints will get stronger, your ability to lift things and run and do things will be better, you'll be more mobile. But also, that lean muscle will help you to boost your metabolism, which in essence is also going to help you to lose fat, okay? So body shape change is using the TD calculator that I'm about to tell you, with one extra step, which will be to help you to work out. Some of the days need to be in calorie surplus, some of the days need to be in calorie deficit. And also you might need to look at the macronutrient content, which is calculating your macros, or if it fits your macros, flexible dieting as it's called, to help you to understand the quality of the calories that you're consuming. So ultimately we plug what you're going to get from your TD calculator over here into our macro calculator and also into creating your 7-day carb cycle formula. Now, both of these are going to be available. This one's going to be available to you. This one takes a little bit more process on why we do it as part of our programs. But both of these will help you to never have to work out what you need to eat again. So there's no more food guilt. You wake up every day knowing what you need to eat when. You eat the right thing at the right time for the right purpose. If you knew that, if you knew exactly, scientifically, to the calorie, to the letter, to the food, to the thing, the recipes, to the everything that you need to be consuming every single day, what would you feel guilty about? Right? There's no more diet hokey-cokey, as we call it, one foot in, one foot out, which is that emotional uncertainty which tends to happen with when, why we have food guilt. There is no, should I be doing this, should I be doing that? It's just, this is the plan I'm following. This is the science. This is telling me exactly what I need to be eating. So why would we need to feel food guilt then? Interesting, right? So this is the answer, ladies. When you know 100% for sure what you need to be consuming for your body, scientifically, and then you implement it, there's no need to feel guilty anymore, because you'll just know what you need to do. So, do you want to have a wee look at the calculator? So remember that the calculator that we're going to give you access to is going to help you to work out your maintenance calories, which is keeping everything the same. You can then mess with the calculator to find out about, you know, getting you into a calorie deficit. However, how we use it as part of our Warrior Goddess Body program, as part of our 7-day carb cycle formula, is we take this information, we plug it into a macro calculator, and then we create our 7-day cycle. So it's going to help you to be in surplus some of the time and in deficit, because macros, calories count per day, macros can be over the space of a week and aren't as strict as calories. So it's not like you would wake up every Monday, like a lot of my clients used to do, weigh themselves and feel like they were 7 pounds heavier because they're just counting calories and counting the scale. The problem with weight loss is that is the way it is. Also, the problem with weight loss is you're weighing a lot of water retention. Whereas with body shape change, the way that we implement our carb element will help you with that water retention and will help you to have a clear understanding of what your body is going to look like, which is what body shape change is, and not about what it says on the scale, which really is not a representation of anything. I mean, I can put on 7 pounds from the morning to the evening quite easily. A lot of ladies I know can do that. So if you were going by that, you'd be miserable every day. You'd wake up absolutely miserable every day. So I'm going to pop the link in with this video. You can also access the link via my bio on Instagram. If you give me a couple of minutes, I'm going to add that in there, so you can access the TD calculator. But if you have any questions, if you're like, Lisa, right, okay, what you're giving me now is basically that there is science behind creating a plan where I know exactly what I need to eat every single day for my body, for the goals that I have, so that I'll never feel food guilt again, then yes, that is true. If you want help with that, that's what our Warrior Goddess Body program is all about. It's helping not only to teach you, it's to give you the tools that I've talked about, help you to teach you to use those tools so that you'll always feel empowered and resourceful when it comes to how to change your body shape, how to have more energy, how to get stronger, how to build lean muscle, all of the goals that you want, and you will never feel guilty about that again. That's what I can promise you. Because once you have the tools, you can't feel guilty, because the only guilt that you can have is whether you follow the program or you don't, which is a separate conversation that we can have for another day. So I hope that was helpful. I'll be live here again for one more Motivation Monday next week before Christmas. And we're going to be talking about the difference between exercise and training and how that works with regards to guilt and motivation, and what exercise I should be doing versus what training I should be doing, and how that whole mindset mindset shift is important if you again want to reach your body shape change goals. So I hope that was helpful. I hope you're having a wonderful Monday. I will see you same time, same place next week for Motivation Monday. And I hope that you're going to enjoy our freebie this week. Just click on the link to access it and let me know how you get on. Peace out.